Okay, so I got a little bit more done because I had another day with decent weather, for most of it anyway. The clouds are starting to come in a little bit now. So we got off the roof on the inside, and that's basically, these have to get pulled back a little bit. Just there's a, like two or three little clips on top get pulled back. You don't have to take them off, just, you know, take off that top tension. The lights, the lens comes off, and then you got these two little bolts, which you can see there, two little bolts. So that takes that off, and that is one of the things that helps hold the roof panel in from the inside. And then the sun visors, here you have two bolts there, and two on the passenger side over there. So those come out, and that comes down. And then the other piece for the sun visors are these little clips, and the sun visor snaps into it like that. The part that faces the windshield has this little opening in the back, and so you push that in with a screwdriver, the whole thing turns, and then when it lines up with this little key slot, it just pulls out. So with the sun visor and those little locks out and the lights out and these two side pillars out and those loosened, this came down, opened, antenna unbolted, taken out, that's a little power wire for it, and this is the reception wire over here, and then we have a little tube for the windshield washer fluid in the back. We'll tidy that up here in a little bit. But so all that's disconnected and opened up. And then on the top, we use that previous grid pattern, and we kind of have a 99% finalized kind of like location within, say, a millimeter or two of how the panels are going to be orientated on the roof. And then I cleaned up some of that gridding that I don't need anymore. And like we kind of said from the beginning, it's not perfectly custom fit like some kind of solar race car. There's a little bit of this unused space, but the unused space I wanted to keep toward the front where it curves more and is more tension and difficult to form fit to. Now, when the weather gets, I'm going to probably maybe put some tape or something over this temporarily so the water doesn't get in for rain if it rains. But And later, the panel will be covering it, so that'll seal it. Now, I'm going to, and there'll be these little penetration points for the plus and minus, plus and minus, plus and minus, for the three panels. The whole thing together is going to be about 825 millimeters front to back and about 790 millimeters side to side. It's going to be a 120 watt of solar. Semi-flexible panels. They're prefabricated, so that's a whole lot easier for me than trying to make a custom panel. Of course, the custom panel would have, you know, got a little bit more space usage. I'm going to grind down or buff down to the metal. I don't want to be binding to the paint, and then I'm only holding on to the paint itself, and if the paint pulls off, then I go with it. I want to bond to the metal itself. So I'm going to buff down to that a little bit, and then I have a 3M very high bond tape that I'm going to be using for bonding. I'm going to leave, since that tape is 19.1 millimeters wide, I'm going to be leaving 8 millimeters here at the border of the trim. I grind that down. That way, when I put the tape down, it will cover that, but leaving that paint intact. So the panels adhered strongly to the metal. Not quite as strongly to the paint, but then the paint stays under it, so it kind of keeps it aesthetic and clean. I don't have to worry about water getting in or the paint, you know, peeling away and chipping from that, because it all will be sealed. And then I also kept myself a little bit away from the border of the car. I wanted to do that so that I could silicone and make little ramp and slope for the edges. That's the other reason why the panels aren't turned the other way. If I turned the other way to fit all the way across three that way, I'd have to come all the way, way, way out, and I wouldn't be able to have this little buffer at the edge. And I didn't like that. I wanted to be able to keep that little buffer, so that's what I'm going to do instead. I think that's about it for now. So there we go. The weather didn't hold out long enough. I'm probably not going to get much more on it today. But that's a nice little bit of progress.